This is February the 14th, 2015. These little darlings are 12 weeks old or will be Monday. This is Saturday. This is their first time out, which they resisted tooth and nail. We had to kind of throw them out because they was determined they wasn't going out. Now, when I first built this house for them, I built a long ramp, and I got to thinking from experience on others, they do not like long ramps. They're scared of them. So, what I done was build them a porch. So they come out of the chicken house and get on their porch and look around. Then they can go down a little short ramp to a second porch and then look around again. And then they can fly to the ground or go down another little short ramp to the ground. So far, the only thing they've used is the porch. I had the top one. I had to throw them off the porch to get them on the ground. They was not coming down, even after Tracy shut the door, so they couldn't get back inside. But I've got 8 lavender Americanas. That's the gray ones that you're looking at. And these are very rare birds. When I got eggs from a guy in Florida last year and actually hatched these out, didn't have a very good return. I got 21 eggs, and out of 21 eggs, only 8 chickens hatched out. Out of those 8 chickens, probably at least half of them are going to be roosters, but Americanas, they're hard to tell at this age because, as you probably know, Americanas do not have a wattle, and their combs are not very big, and so it makes it very hard to tell. That's the only thing you can go by is the rounded tail feathers for a hen and the pointed one for a rooster. That's right. Listen to me, baby. They hear my voice. They've never... nobody's messed with them except me mainly, and they've seen Tracy a couple of times. So when they hear my voice, they stretch their neck. They think I'm mama. Oh, here comes some more out this way. Going back out into the sun. But before I let them out this morning, in the first food container there, I put some crack corn. And in the second one, I put what they're used to, which is a starter grower. It's a mesh. And so they are pretty well tearing up both of them. It's February the 14th here in Alabama, and which means it's still cold. I know we're from the south, but we get cold down here too. In fact, it's freezing every night. And I had to wait this morning until it got above freezing before I could do all this, because they have been inside that chicken house for over a month, probably a month and a half, I guess. And I have put more bedding down on top of what they had, but it was getting to where it was kind of smelly, and I wanted to do something about that. So I got the chickens out. It was time for them to hit the ground anyway. So I got the chickens out. Cleaned out the chicken house, put new bedding down and some diatomaceous earth to kill any mites that might be in there. So, hopefully, they'll be smart enough to find their way back into the chicken house, which I truly doubt. Chickens are not known to be very smart. I bought me a 5-gallon waterer for the outside, which you see that lavender Americana getting a drink of right there. Now, that's the first time I've used it. I just filled it up this morning and set it out before I turned them out. And Yeah, actually, they when we was Tracy was on the inside pushing them out, and they would just turn around and come right back in. So she finally, after she got a porch full, she shut the door so they couldn't get back in. And then she went around to the side and she opened my clean out doors. As you can see right here, I've got two huge clean out doors. Well, she opened those two out and she chunked the rest of them out through the clean out door. But they was determined they was not coming out. Of course, they would eventually would have left them, but it's probably been 2 or 3 hours before they got out. And we kindly needed for them to go on out so we could clean it out. But yeah, they're checking things out. This is the first time out in a run, and they got plenty of room. The run is 50 by 50. And they've got another pen here that I built last year sometime. And I can put roosters, setting hens, whatever in this. I built this as a tractor. And I made it as light as I could, really. But it was still too heavy. So, I had to pull it around with my lawnmower. Pull it with my John Deere. So, I got to right there, and I finally just said, this is it. I'll build the chicken run around this thing, and I can use it inside. So that's what I did. And then last week, I built another little section right here onto it. One of the main reasons was